Everyone, it's Marian here with my new channel, a little bit of this and a little bit of that, and I welcome you all here. We'll be talking about a lot of different crafts here, and to start off with, I'll be telling you about my latest crochet work. I'm working on a graph gun of a fairy silhouette. This is the pattern that I'm working on, and I found it on Pinterest. It's 105 wide and 105 tall, but what I've done is at the bottom there are a lot of plain stitches, and at the top it finishes very abruptly, which I don't like. So what I've done is that I've skipped almost 11 rows from the bottom, kept two plain here and one plain, and I'm going to have two plain at the top as well, because here it gives you one, I'll keep two. So it takes my height, the height of my project, to around 95 to 96 rows. Okay, I am working in the background with this color. It's double knit robin. I love this color, and my fairy silhouette is going to be with this color, red. Okay, now for those of you who've never done graph guns and are a little intimidated by them, I'm working mine in single stitch. This is the first time I'm working a graph gun in single stitch. I usually do them in half double crochet, but I've noticed that if you do half double crochet, you have this tiny little holes showing in between once you're done with your project, which don't look bad but don't look very appealing as well. Whereas if it's single stitch, you can see that it's very closely aligned, and this is what I like to see in my work. I like to see my work more pronounced. What I'm doing here is that I've started on my new color, and those of you who are not familiar with single crochet, this is for you. You just insert hook in your work, pull out a loop, and pull through both loops. Again, insert hook, pull out a loop. You have two loops on your hook, pull through both loops. Insert hook, pull out a loop, pull through both loops. Insert hook, pull out a loop, pull through both loops. I'll post the link to the pattern below. You're almost welcome to take a printout of it, to get a printout, and we'll work together on it. I'll be posting my progress every now and then as I keep moving on. Now, you must have seen that most of the people, they like working on their graph guns using bobbins. I personally don't like bobbins. They're a mess. The yarn gets tangled. So I'm more of that snip and tie person. But everybody has their preferences. Bobbins are just not my thing. If they're yours, please go for them. Okay. I'm going to move ahead with it, and before I stop the video, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to show you how to change the color the way I do, the snip and tie method, and it would be nice if you all start working on this. I mean, if you people decide that you want to work on the pattern, then I'm going to leave the link for below. Please start working on it and keep showing me your progress, because as I see your comments, I see the way you people respond, then I'm going to make a few tutorials as well. For, sorry, excuse me, this, crochet, graphtons, granny squares, hearts, baskets, and also we'll be doing some cross stitch together. Cross stitch is one of my favorite things after crochet, of course. And I'll be working on a portrait of my mom, a black and white one that I made the pattern for. And I'm planning to gift it to her on Mother's Day. Okay, now this is my last stitch here. Okay, I'm not going to finish it, of course. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to snip it, take my background yarn, and I'm going to finish the stitch here. Then what I'm going to do is that I'm going to take both the ends. I'm going to take both the ends and I'm going to tie up a knot. And of course, when I'm done, I'm going to weave in the ends. That's the most hard part of any project, but makes everything worthwhile here. Now I'm going to carry on with my background yarn. Oops. If you want, you can run your tails behind your work, and then after taking them through two, three stitches, you can cut them out. It's totally up to you. Me, I sometimes do it, other times I don't because I really don't like the way it looks from under your work. I'll show you a few that I've run through, but the problem is that both my colors are opposite ends. Like one is too bright and the other is also bright but in a different context. So the red yarn shows from under the yellow one, and the yellow one shows from under the red one, which I'm not very fond of. Here is where I ran the yarn through. Here, and you can see that it is showing from under my work. Even here, look, you can see little snippets of yellow. Not a green fan of that. Okay, I'll be posting my progress off and on, so please, if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. If you don't like it, give me a thumbs down and respond. Okay, I'll see you soon. Take care. Bye bye.